So all these tools here will be part of the temporary LFS system. And then once we've got that temporary LFS system, that's the minimal number of packages that are required to build Linux from scratch. It says recall improper setting of LFS together with buildings root may render your computer usable. So that's just worth that bearing in mind. And it says the whole chapter must be run as user LFS. So we stay as we are. We don't need to do anything. We just carry on as we have been. So this is M4. So a lot of these packages are a little bit smaller now, so they're going to take a lot less time to build. And a lot of the instructions for building is quite similar, as you'll see. So run a configure command. Build it. And install it. And that's done. So you can see that took maybe less than a minute to build. So remove the source directory and carry on to the next package, which is ncurses. And now we can start running the commands in for this package. So, as I said on the configure, then we make a build directory. Push D, so we're saving the directory we're in. We're running the configure from the build directory. So this is just allowing us to build this tick program. Build everything in the include directory and then everything in these two. Or rather, sorry, the tick program, which is in the progs directory. And pop D to go back to where we were. And now we can build ncurses properly. Build it with make. And install it with these two commands, well, install with this command. And then little files created here. And that's the end of it. Always worth scrolling down to the bottom of the page for each package, just to ensure you don't miss out any commands. Sometimes, like, I think it was in the, I'll just go back. Yeah, this GDBC page, there's this one command right at the very bottom. So if we'd sort of, oh, that's it there, we just tested it, it's okay. you wouldn't have seen that, it would have missed it, and it's important to the build. So it's worth, before clicking to go on, don't click up here, scroll to the bottom and just ensure that you haven't missed any instructions. So let's remove end curses. And we can now extract bash. And we go straight into a configure command. As you can see, it's fairly straightforward again to build this. Make and install. And finally, a symlink. And that's it. We can move on to the next one, which is core utils. Let's clean up the bash source directory, and we need to extract core utils. And again, I'm tabbing it, and it's not completing, and that's because there's a patch file. So I just press dot to get the rest of the tarball file name. It's extracted, change into it, and now we can configure. Okay, so let's build it. And install. And then we've got some changes to make. So all that is one command. Not sure why they've laid it out like this. It looks a bit strange, but each line is one command. Moving a few files around, making a few changes to the installation. And that's core utils done. So move now onto diff utils. So configure. Build it. And install it. And that's the few tools done. Move now onto file. So here we've got a make the build command, so I'm making a temporary build. We're going into it with push D temporarily. One config command. You can see why we're doing this. It says the file command on the build host needs to be the same version as one we're building in order to create the signature file. So that's why we're doing this bit. Let's build it. That's done. So pop D just brings us back to where we were. And now we can do the actual final configuration and build. Built, install it, and that's complete. We want to find utils. So now we run configure. Make. And install it. And that's complete. So we can now tidy up. And move on to Gawk. Got set command. Configure. And run make to build it. And install it. That's complete. Remove the source directory and we move on to the next package, which is grep. So once again, configure. Build it with make. And install, and that's done. Move on to the next package, which is gzip. figure command, similar to before. Make to build it and install it. Next package is make, so we're going to make if you like. Run the configure command. Build it and install it. That's done. Next package we're going to build is patch. Once again, got configuration command. Build it. And install it. And that's complete. So move on to sed next. So these are all basic utilities that are being built that should be, for any development system, should be central to the Linux system. And maybe even for any other system actually said, should be part of a standard system. So configure, make, install. It's done. Move on to tar. And again, it's configure. Build it. And install. So that's finished. Tidy up the source directory and move on to XZ. So once again, configure. Build the package. Install it. That's complete. So now move on to bin utils 2.37 pass 2. So again, we have to extract the package, which is ensure there's no existing directory, change into it, and then we can run in the commands. So configure. See how long this one's going to take. 1.3. So you can see the first package was bin utils, but now it's going to take a little bit longer because probably more going to be built in this version of it that we're going to build now. So make, wait a couple of minutes, and then we'll be able to install it. Okay, that's finished. We'll install it. And there's one extra install command here to run in. That's done. Go back to the sources and tidy up the bin utils source directory. And we've gone to GCC2 to build that for the second time. So change into it, and we've got these commands here. I'm just going to run these in because they're fairly simple commands. They didn't produce a lot of output, and as you can see, they've worked correctly, so that's fine. Run this compound command again, and create a separate build directory. Directory for libgcc and create a link as well. And now we can run the configure command. And build a package. Okay, so that's finished. 18 minutes. That only took fractionally longer than previously. Install. And make one symlink. And that's GCC past two builds.